Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to SmackDown. We are live in Orlando, Florida, and we have a hell of a... All right, ladies and gentlemen, kicking things off tonight, we have the United States Champion in a match with the World Heavyweight Champion. It is champion versus champion in Orlando tonight. And those resounding boos can only mean one thing. It's the approach of our United States Champion, Rusev. They are definitely not his biggest fans here in Orlando. Looks like Rusev's doing a little DDP yoga before his match. And here comes the World Heavyweight Champion, Dean Ambrose. To start things off. And Ambrose with the assault early on, sending Rusev to the floor. Pandering to the crowd now as Rusev slides back in and chops from the world champion. Shoots Rusev off in the knee to the gut. And again. And followed by the Russian leg sweep. Rusev with the reversal. Oh, and plows him into the corner. Oh, Ambrose moved. Float over. Oh, Rusev. Rusev. Battling out, avoiding the DDT, and then running through Ambrose. And now, Rusev stomping away. Rusev with the size and power advantage, making that abundantly clear. This is a false count anywhere match, ladies and gentlemen. Which means everything is legal. I would not want... Oh, he hit the ref! He got the ref and Rusev at the same time. Dean Ambrose is not somebody I would trust with a baseball bat. and a DDT on the floor. And now Ambrose with a series of right hands. And a nice elbow there. It looked like Rusev was going to reverse it, but Ambrose able to maintain control. And a clothesline. Nice forearm shot there. Oh, and Rusev with the fireman's carry. And now it's Ambrose with the reversal. Oh, and what a clothesline. He just clotheslined Rusev out of his boots. What is the world champ doing now? He's got Rusev trapped up on the pole there. What is he? A nice clubbing blow. Oh, this doesn't look good. Oh my God! We're gonna need medics. Rusev has to have a concussion after a blow like that. Ambrose going for the pin. This is a false count anywhere match. One, two, three. And the World Heavyweight Champion is victorious over the United States Champion here in SmackDown's opening match. This was how it all started, and this was how it ended, with that big boot trapping Rusev's head between Ambrose's foot and the steel post. Could have counted to 100. Heavyweight champion certainly looks to be ready for Extreme Rules this coming Sunday. The only question now is, who's he going to face? All right, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have one half of the tag team champions in Scott Hall taking on a representative from the corporation in Enforcer. And here's a man making his SmackDown debut, representing the corporation. We have the Enforcer. Enforcer stands about 5'10", weighing, tipping the scales at 300 pounds. He does not look like he's dressed to wrestle. But apparently that suit top comes off very quickly. And now, representing the Wolf Pack, we have Scott Hall, one half of the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. to go, ladies and gentlemen. This is not a false count anywhere match. They're going to have to keep this one in the ring and enforce her with those right hands. Locking it up and a nice knee to the face, followed by a belly-to-belly suplex. You want to talk about dominance? Oh my God, with the super kick. Setting him up now. A nice vertical suplex. The flurry of strikes happen early, perhaps to set Scott Hall off his game. And now, Enforcer making use of that low center of gravity to just manhandle this bigger man. But Scott Hall with the fireman's carry, able to battle back. And now Scott Hall with an impressive throw. Enforcer able to free himself from Scott Hall, but Scott Hall is still in this fight. And a shoulder block from Scott Hall. Enforcer trying to get to his feet, got a boot to the midsection, as now Scott Hall's just stomping away on him. But the Enforcer is up. He's got Hall hooked, and a nice suplex there. And a nice vertical suplex, snap suplex, right floating over into a pin. One count only. The Enforcer moving quickly, not wanting to lose control of this matchup, but Scott Hall with the reversal. And Hall's got him up in a power slam. And oh, and now just scraping his foot across the face. Pulling back on it, raking at the eyes. He shoots him off into the ropes. And a power slam. Scott Hall is ruling this match. Oh, but a strong kick out from the Enforcer. And the Enforcer battles back. Scott Hall with the snapmare. Scott Hall shoots him off into the corner. Oh! And now, to the outside! Scott Hall sent him to the outside! Hall's gonna follow him. The referee will start the count. This is not a false count anywhere match. These men can be counted out as the Enforcer sent Scott Hall into the steps. Referee count up to three. Oh, this is a... Oh my God! The Enforcer just... Beard! A Hall straight through the barricade! And the crowd, this Orlando crowd, voicing their approval. The Enforcer back in the ring. Apparently the Enforcer would be okay with a count-out victory. Hall stirring. Can Scott Hall beat the 10 count? A count of nine. If you're gonna do it, you better hurry up. He made it in. And a super kick. That must have just been out of sheer frustration. And now the Enforcer stomping away. And a nice suplex. Where is the Enforcer going? The Enforcer has a baseball bat. This is not a no disqualification match. Wait a second. He just knocked down the referee. And now he's assaulting Scott Hall with that bat. He's going for the pin. Scott Hall got the ropes. And a neck breaker. Enforcer pacing. I'm not sure he knows what to do with himself at this point. He's pulling Scott Hall up. Oh, just reversal after reversal here, folks. Oh, and another belly-to-belly suplex. A nice fireman's carry. Showing his power here. And a power bomb. Scott Hall with the snapmare. Scott Hall driving his shoulders into his elbows into the shoulders of the enforcer. Scott Hall going to the pin. One. And a kick out after one. Scott Hall throwing up that hand signal. Oh, and an insulting slap across the face. Scott Hall apparently feeling very confident in his amount of control over this matchup. Oh, and a nice arm drag from the enforcer. And another power bomb. Breaker to Hall. And a nice suplex. Hall battling back. And a nice forearm shot. Oh, he caught the leg. He caught the leg. And a reversal from Hall. Both of these men back and forth, back and forth. And now Hall back in control. Hall going for, oh! Hall was going for a choke slam. Enforcer turned it into a DDT! And another power bomb! And a nice suplex from the enforcer. He's just throwing Scott Hall around like he is a rag doll, ladies and gentlemen. But there's Hall with that arm drag once again. And a right hand, a series of right hands. Enforcer's up. And the enforcer making a comeback here. But Scott Hall was able to... Scott Hall was able to reverse it. And there's Scott Hall with the jawbreaker. And Scott Hall able to battle out of the vertical suplex. Looks like Paul's putting him up on top of the turnbuckle. Paul setting him up for what, I'm not sure. Oh, God! All the way across the room, Scott Hall threw him. Going for the pin. And a kick out at one. Paul pandering to the crowd now. Apparently confident that this one is over. Oh, and the reversal! And the powerbomb! And Hall battling back. Hall managing to escape the power slam. Hall's bloodied, but he is not out of this fight. And there's a suplex. Enforcer looks like he's favoring that shoulder. Paul trying to make it to his feet here. Oh, he dodged the drop kick. And another belly to belly suplex. I think frustration is mounting. Top Supersito. The Enforcer going aerial now. It's uncharacteristic of somebody of his weight to go aerial. He went for a frog splash, but Scott Hall moved. And a reversal. And the Enforcer is feeling it. And another powerbomb. I get the feeling that he's not just trying to win this match anymore. He might be trying to hurt Scott Hall at this point. And the fireman's carry. Throwing Hall across the ring. And another backbreaker. He is just assaulting the spine of Scott Hall. And another neckbreaker. God. And he powerbombed him again. What on earth is the Enforcer thinking? I guarantee you he could pin him right now. Maybe not. And Hall with a power slam of his own. Don't sell the tag team champion short, ladies and gentlemen. Going for the pin. Oh, but a kick out. Hall has not done nearly as much damage to the Enforcer as the Enforcer has done to him. And shoots him off into the steps. Oh, and now Hall sends Enforcer into the steps. Oh my goodness. Oh, into the steps. Referees count up to five. The Enforcer pandering to the crowd. Up to seven. And Scott Hall's back in the ring. Enforcer shoots him off into the corner. Oh, he's perching him up top. What's he going for now? We're looking at, is that a superplex? No, no. Butterfly suplex from the top rope. Is that gonna be it? One, two, three. That's it. Scott Hall's not moving. It was just an all-out assault on the spine of Scott Hall during this match. The midsection of the tag team champion was just obliterated throughout this match. You know, it was a back and forth contest, but Scott Hall definitely took the brunt of the damage, as we see here, as it ended with that butterfly suplex off the top turnbuckle. And after the landing, Hall's just, he didn't move. He moves his arms a little bit, but his, I don't know, ladies and gentlemen. We may need to get the, he's rolled out of the ring now. I think our doctors are going to have to take a look at Scott Hall. What a debut for the Enforcer. Ladies and gentlemen, next up is going to be a special match, as we have Carnage, who's going to go one-on-one with Death. Death making his debut here tonight. Carnage, of course, we've seen over on Raw, and he has been dominant on Raw. And tonight we are going to see him in the ring with somebody much, much larger than he is. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for our main event. And here comes a man we've gotten to know over the last couple of weeks on Raw. This is Carnage. From what we've seen of Carnage so far, he has been very, very dominant. And tonight we're going to see what he can do against Death. We have seen this man submit Titus O'Neil. We have seen him go toe-to-toe and hold his ground with the gigantic Sasquatch. And we have seen him win clean over the Universal Champion. But tonight could be his toughest challenge yet, as he goes up against the 7'4", 640-pound horseman known as Death. A smile on the face of Carnage. He may be taking this a little too lightly, and here he is, ladies and gentlemen. The moment we've been waiting for, the SmackDown debut of Death. look at the size of this man. Most competitors, their neck sits about at the top rope. That's where his waist is. One of the largest competitors we have ever seen on SmackDown. And certainly one of the most dangerous. And here we go as Carnage gears up for what could be his toughest challenge yet. Death in his SmackDown debut. Look at the size difference. Oh, and Death going right to work, hammering on Carnage. Carnage, but Carnage is not going to just take it lying down as he STOs on Death. Oh, and now we got right hands. Oh, and just the power of Death shoving Carnage away. But Carnage is not down and out. He's going to keep fighting. Right hand and another. Just a series of punches from Carnage to Death. Just trying to wear the big man down. Oh, and a knee to the gut. As Carnage says, no, I don't want to be power slammed. Carnage stomping away on Death, trying to chop the big man down. Death out to the floor. Oh, and a nice kick from Carnage. And a good shot to the gut. Just back and forth. And a neck breaker from Carnage. And a power bomb. And Carnage. Carnage had the rolling knee bar there. But Death was close enough to the ropes. And now Death battling out. I think Carnage has decided he wants to focus on the leg. Oh my God. Oh, but Death just still has too much in the tank. And a nice running STO. Oh, and Carnage just attacking that knee. How do you take a big man down? You chop him out at the legs. But Death is just simply not done yet. Oh, and Carnage battles out. Oh, and a nice kick. And more assault to the knee. Even more on the knee. This is a modified Indian Deathlock, tearing the knees apart. Death once again able to power out. Straightjacket DDT! That'll rattle your brain. I don't care how tough you are. Oh, but again, Death able to power out. Carnage keeps going back to the legs, but I don't think he's done enough damage yet. Oh, choke slam. Oh, he goes up and down. That is a long way down, ladies and gentlemen. Carnage trying to get to his feet now. Oh, Death tried to head him off. Carnage able to battle out. And he just ran the 640-pounder. Oh, oh! You know somebody's strong when a punch from their back puts you on the mat. Oh, no. Oh! Death looked like he was going for a straight jacket DDT. but Carnage was able to power out of it. What's Carnage is going for he was going for some sort of modified sharpshooter, but Death was too close to the ropes. That's the problem with these tall competitors. It's harder to get them in a position where they can't reach the ropes. Oh, and a kick to the gut. What is Carnage doing here? Oh, no. The referee's not going to like this. He's got a five count to break the hold. Oh, my God. Ring figure four around the ring post. Death able to block the suplex and answer with a suplex of his own. Carnage back in the ring. Death following. Oh, and a nice punch there. Oh. Oh my God. Carnage now dragging Death to the middle of the ring. What's he gonna go for here? Well, this looks like a modified figure four leg lock. Is he gonna make Death tap? Death's tapping! Death's tapping! Carnage is victorious once again. I don't believe it. There's a straitjacket DDT as we look back, and a choke slam. This one went back and forth more times than a tennis match, but it ended in the center of the ring with a modified figure four and with Death tapping out to Carnage. Will this man ever cease to amaze us?